Jacob here with Sarracenia Northwest, and this is your carnivorous plant care guide for October 2024. At the start of the fall season, many Sarracenia are looking awesome. We're seeing lots of colorful pictures, ranging from sublime to downright jaw-dropping. These late season plants are showing off their best pictures of the season. They often don't look great early in the season, but when we get into fall, you'll see that the wait was well worth it. Many of these pitchers will also last into early winter, even after a series of frost. Now on the flip side, Sarracenia flava, Oreophylla, and their hybrids are shutting down for the season. Their pitchers are already turning brown and flopping over. There's nothing wrong with these plants. They just grow on a different cycle than other varieties of Sarracenia, peaking in early summer rather than in early fall. Fly traps will slow down this month. They'll gradually drop their upright traps and produce shorter ones that lay closer to the soil. Hardy sundews at our nursery still have lots of leaves, but eventually they will drop their leaves as the days get cooler and shorter. By the end of October, they will form a resting bud right on the soil surface. Now we're located in the Pacific Northwest, and October is when the clouds roll in and the weather cools significantly. In some parts of the country, you might see an overnight frost this month. That's okay. Outdoor perennials can tolerate an overnight frost. In fact, the overnight frost combined with shorter days will trigger your outdoor plants to go dormant. Now, if you're in USDA Zone 6 or colder, you should start thinking about winter dormancy and how you plan to do that. We have a video specifically about winter care, which is part of our Grow Carnivorous Plants Volume 1 playlist. You can find the link to the playlist down below or at the end of this video. But for the rest of October, you don't need to do anything special for your plants. Now, regardless of your zone, continue giving your plants water by ensuring the trays are filled. Never allow the soil to dry out. Your plants will still need water even during winter dormancy. Just make sure the water level remains below the halfway point of your pot. Sunlight might be less critical in late season, but make sure your Sarracenia and flytraps are still getting as much sunlight as possible. This is especially true if you live in southern regions and have a long growing season. If your Sarracenia has a burst of new pitchers, trim off the older ones that are primarily brown and flopping over. You will bring more attention to the spectacular fall pitchers this way. Now, even though we're getting late in the season, you can still add plants to your collection, especially if you have a long growing season. Many of the outdoor perennials are currently on sale. Go to our website at growcarnivorousplants.com to see what's available. Tropical sundews and butterworts are looking fantastic this month. They're all producing lots of new growth now that the temperature is much more stable in the greenhouse. Nepenthes are also enjoying the milder conditions of autumn. We recently removed the shade cloth, which let in a lot more sunlight, so we're seeing more pitchers popping up and developing nice colors. Even though the temperature outside is cooling down, it's not yet cold enough to turn on the propane heaters. That will likely happen by the third week of October. With all of your tropical plants, ensure that the soil is always hydrated. You can keep sundews in standing water, but as we get into the cooler months, you might find that you won't need as much water as you did during summer. Just make sure the soil never dries out. With your tropical butterworts and Nepenthes, water them like regular houseplants. Let the water drain through completely, and always make sure the soil feels slightly damp to the touch. Now in October and upcoming months, the sun will be lower in the sky, so consider moving your tropical plants to a south window for maximum sunlight. Otherwise, consider using artificial lights. Watch our video about LED lights for more information. You can find the link down below or at the end of this video. And if you want to add tropical plants to your collection, we have many in stock. We have a fresh crop of Nepenthes cuttings and Heliamphora divisions. Visit growcarnivorousplants.com to see what's in stock. Thank you so much for watching. I look forward to seeing you in another video.